Good morning. How are you guys?
Doing great. Hey, man, thanks for doing this.
Oh, no worries. Not at all.
You know, one of the things that Stephanie and I pride ourselves on is asking our guests questions that nobody else, and I know you're doing a lot of press, doing a lot of radio, but so I thought we'd start with a question I'm positive nobody else has asked. What did Mike Tyson throw up in his mask?
I was on the Will Smith shoot, so.
Oh, it was?
Mike Tyson throw up in his mask.
Was it Will Smith or Mike Tyson?
I know Will didn't.
Oh, okay.
I know Will didn't throw up in his mouth. Will was like a champ.
Okay.
That guy came at it, like, to tell you the truth.
So you don't know the answer to the question, then?
To Mike, no.
Oh, okay.
I know that he was very intimidated and afraid, genuinely, like, you know, intimidated by them. But he seems to be very, very open and, like you know, he doesn't have anything that he's trying to cover up to anybody or, you know, make himself feel tough or anything else like that. You see Mike react to something that he's intimidated by, I think that's real.
Yeah, he's a lot different than he used to be. So what the reports are that he threw up in his mask or something like that, and maybe it's just hype for the week or whatever it happens to be, but I find it...
No, I would believe it. Okay. I would believe it. Out of the people that did that, I would believe they would have said that.
Yeah.
He threw up in his mask. And it happens quite commonly, believe it or not. It's just, you know, you're in weightlessness and you're upside down and you're doing all that stuff. That's not something you're used to. So
yeah,
when
I suppose.
You become weightless, that's a lot to it. And then you add the nerves of the sharks on top of it, it does it to you.
Yeah, and there's a shark there, you know. That's going to make you a little queasy.
And a shark there.
Yeah.
So, Joe, this is my question.
Where he's actually throwing up.
Sure. Okay.
How many years has Shark Week been on now? This is the what anniversary?
32nd.
32nd.
Okay. This is ridiculous. Don't get me wrong. I love sharks. I love all sorts of sea life. I just feel like, haven't we learned everything that there is to know about sharks? What about Octopus Week? Or Cuttlefish Week? Or Otter Week?
Watch the Dory movies. You'll find out all about that crap.
Well, I'll tell you the truth. The otter deserves its own week.
Thank you.
I mean, to speak on that, the great white shark is probably the most looked at shark in the world. Probably one of the most looked at animals in the entire world.
Sure. Yeah.
We've still not seen that animal. We still don't know where that animal mates. We still don't know where that animal gives birth. Like, we have suspicions. We've never seen it. Now, there are 500 different species of these animals. We've only touched a grain of rice in a whole bag of them.
Yeah. and also,
so many different aspects to study these animals.
We're here with Joe Romero, Shark Week, of course, on Discovery. And I just want to say thank you so much for placating Stephanie with that answer. I just thought that was adorable.
No, it's a genuine question.
Yeah, no, it definitely was a genuine question.
I think a lot of people go to areas where they go, well, what are you guys going to be able to do next? You've been doing it 35 years.
Yeah.
That's a natural one. You know, I think you got to hand it off to these. Like, you know, everybody at Discovery Channel, all my colleagues, Howard Schwartz, Candace Allgood, all these people that work really hard to make it happen. Lori Goldberg, I feel like they had to deal with one of the most difficult years in the history of the United States.
Absolutely.
They not only did well, they thrived in this area.
So, Joe...
And they did so well that Shark Week's amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, okay, so Discovery Channel, we all know that they have, you know, a crush on sharks. But you, as far as a cinematographer and, you know, studier of all things sea life... What is it about the shark that you are specifically drawn to?
I think it was one of those animals that I felt like was just incredibly beautiful. And I think that the traits that animal holds are all ones that we all really hold dear. And it's like the animal's, you know, mysterious, dangerous. It has freedom unknown to us. All this stuff that mystery surrounds its life. It's like all these traits that you kind of almost want to see in yourself. You know, like these things that make them iconic, these things that make you respect them in a way. Because, you know, to be honest, it goes back to what you said. There's no Panda Week.
Right?
And there should be.
But there should be an Otter Week. I'm glad that you agree with me on this. Joe, in all the years that you have been studying and filming these creatures, have you seen an effect of climate change on their environments?
Well, right now the studies are starting to go in as far as like getting scientific, like scientific facts are like one of those things that it's almost so completely obvious before everybody will peer review and understand that we all agree on this. This is happening.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, there's a lot of motivation on all sides to do what is on their agenda. But I will say this, like, I definitely have seen a difference in water temperature. I've seen a drive in sharks moving, and I'm out there all the time.
Right.
I've been out there all season. In the last 2 months, I've probably done 20 days out there, and I'm telling you, it's different. It's definitely different than what it was.
We're here with Joe Romero, of course, Shark Week on Discovery. So, Joe, the other obvious question is, what do you have a close call with a shark? I mean, have you been bitten?
I gotta like find some wood. No.
Wow, I got nervous. I thought this interview was taking a different turn.
Severely, you know, it's like I think it's a lot of the things, like it's the things you're not looking at. You know, it's like I've had 20 something camera lenses like destroyed. I've had cameras taken out of my hands by sharks. I've had all kinds of different situations, and I think the things that I worry about the most are like the box jellyfish, like a jellyfish that's so tiny you can't really even see
right?
it. And yet it has it's 100 times more toxic and venomous than the cobra.
Wow.
Right.
All right. I can't wait to get back to the Caribbean.
We're filming sharks, and we have them and saltwater crocodiles.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay. Enough, hero.
All right. Joe Romero, everybody. It's Shark Week on Discovery. Joe, thanks a lot for doing this, man. And stay safe, will you?